Hey Stevie, I have a customer asking, how do you use external autofill keyword sets in OnBase?
Hey Austin, I'd be happy to show you that. Let me share my screen. External autofill keyword sets provide the same benefit as an internal autofill keyword set, except that it allows you to pull from an external database, such as the CRM system or wherever you're storing the data that you want to have mapped to the keyword types. So let's configure one. If we go into keyword and keyword types, the first thing you want to do is create the keyword that you want associated with your autofill keyword set. In this particular instance, we're going to use employee ID, employee full name, and employee department. If we go into the settings of any one of these keywords, settings, I did change the data type from numeric to alphanumeric with a maximum character length of 150. Now, of course, this could depend or change in your environment based upon your business need, but that's what we have here. So we can go ahead and hit save. Close that out. Next thing you want to go to is keyword, autofill keyword sets. You want to configure your autofill keyword set. I named mine employee data. We're going to go into each of these options here. So if we open keywords, we have the three keywords I want associated with the autofill keyword set, led by my primary keyword type, which is employee ID. Save that out and go into settings. One of the most important buttons here, and the only really needed button, is to select this external autofill keyword set. If you don't, you won't have the ability to modify any of the settings here under external. So if you notice that you don't have access to that external option, you just want to go back and check that radio button. Now, if you go into external, here is where you want to enter your SQL select string. You can create your own. There's one listed in the MRG as well. After you enter your SQL select string, you want to make sure that you enter the data source name and the user ID and password for that database. Now, typically we recommend using the viewer account. You don't really need to give it HSI permission, but in this particular instance, I did use the HSI account. Now, before saving out of this box, good rule of thumb is to ensure that you test. Let's make sure it works. Whatever the employee ID you test here may be different based upon your environment. Maybe all of your employee IDs are numeric, but in this particular instance, it is a name. So test is always going to make you confirm the database password. Perfect. We're getting key set results, so we know it's working. So we'll go ahead and save out of here. The user group, you want to make sure you assign a user group so that you can actually utilize the autofill keyword set. For testing purposes here, we have our manager group. We're going to go ahead and close this out. Last but not least, you want to make sure that you have the document type configured, which I have here, and that you have the keywords associated with the document type and the autofill keyword set linked with the document type as well. It's very, very important in order for this to work. And we'll save out. Close. Fine. And we're going to reset the cache of the app servers. Now, let's put all of this into theory. We're going to open up the OnBase client. Of course, you can do the same steps within the Unity client or your client of choice. So we're going to go ahead and import the document in. We're going to type in the primary keyword and then hit tab. There you go. It fills in the employee full name and the employee department, which makes indexing a breeze.
Thanks for watching. Make sure to hit that subscribe button and give us a thumbs up. If you have a question that you would like answered on an upcoming question corner, please leave a comment below.